Hello, dear student. I'm Dr. Chandrakala HT. Welcome to the online class on the subject Programming Language Using C. In this video, I'll be introducing you to C language. First, let us see the history of C. So before the C language came into existence, there were many other previous languages which were developed, and these languages led to the gradual development of C. So as you all know, the programming language which is most preferred by the programmers is a high-level language, since the other two types of languages, machine language and assembly language, have their own disadvantages when it comes to programming. People started to prefer using high-level languages for programming the computer. Way behind in 1960, the language ALGOL, which was a high-level language, was in use. So this ALGOL came into existence in 1960. This language was further modified into the language BCPL. So ಈಗ ಆಲ್ಗೋಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಬರೆಯಬಹುದಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅದೊಂದಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ ಯೂಸ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆಲ್ಗೋಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಇದೆ, ಏನು ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಬೆಟರ್ ಆಗ್ತಿತ್ತು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಸೇ ಇವಾಗ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ವೇರ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಬೆಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ನ, ಈ ಥರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಕ್ರೈಟೀರಿಯಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾರ್ಟಿನ್ ರಿಚರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಒಬ್ರು ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ BCPL ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ನ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. BCPL ಇಸ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಇನ್ 1967. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫ್ಯೂ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ 1970 ಕೆನ್ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಬಿ. ಸೊ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ BCPL ಅಂಡ್ ALGOL. ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ದನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ 1972 ಡೆನ್ನಿಸ್ ರಿಚಿ, a computer scientist who was working in the AT&T Bell Laboratories of the US, he developed a traditional C language. Okay, since he used many of the features present in the B language, he named the language, his new language, as C, because it was a better version of the language B. So this traditional C language was developed with the aim to write an operating system called Unix. To develop an operating system called Unix, he developed this C language. So the Unix operating system was written completely using the C language. Later, in 1978, Kernighan and Dennis Ritchie, who were colleagues at AT&T Bell Laboratories, they wrote a book and published a book on C language. So this C language was popularly called as K&RC. So after this book was published, the C language became very popular, and people read the book, they installed C language and started to use C language for programming. Within very few years, C became a very popular and most used high-level programming language. So after a few years of usage, the American National Standards Institute, ANSI, it formed a committee in order to standardize C, to make it as a universal standard programming language. So universal means it's global, it's common for all the continents and countries throughout the world. In order to make it such a standard, ANSI formed a committee in 1989, and they standardized the C language. They standardized most of the features of C language, and this modified and standardized version of C language was called as ANSI C. So in 1990, the International Standards Organization, that is ISO, also standardized this particular C language further. So standardizations in the enagutte andre, it guarantees the quality of that particular product. So it became a standard product. So that added more value to that particular language. After the standardization, it became much more valuable. So that was in 1990. Next, in 1999, yet another standardization was done for C. So C99 was developed. And why this was developed was, between the time 1990 to 1999, from C language, C++ and Java were developed. So these two languages were much more powerful languages compared to C, because they supported object-oriented concepts. So after these two came, people felt that C could be enhanced by adding a few more features. And those features, additional features to add to the power of the C, were done. And again, the C was standardized in 1999, yet another time. And that version of C was called as C99. And this version is what is still in use today. So after C language, numerous programming languages have come into being. But still, C has its own value and user base because of its good qualities. In fact, it is still the most powerful and most used high-level programming language. So now, let's move on to the importance of C. So, ivaga nan helidange eshtu hosa languages bandmelu saha C language innu use allide yake adu innu use allide annadana nodana. Let's see the importance of C. So, C is popular because it has many desirable and good qualities. C is a robust language. So robust language, why? Because it has a rich set of built-in functions and rich set of operators available. Using these, we can write any sort of complex program. It can support any sort of complex program writing, since it has a rich, robust set of built-in functions and operators. C language is having the capabilities of both assembly language as well as high-level language. Therefore, it's very suitable to write even system softwares as well as application softwares. Also, the C programs are efficient and fast. So compared to all other previous languages, C programs execute at a very fast rate because of its powerful data types and operators. So to give you an example, a program which had to increment a variable from 0 to 15,000 takes about 1 second in C language, but it took around 50 seconds in the basic language. Okay, so basic language was a language which was there before C language. Okay, so after the C99 version came, of course, the C language speed is quite comparable to Java and C++ as well, the newer languages. Almost comparable speed can be achieved still with the C language. C language also has a rich set of keywords. It has 32 keywords, which have predefined meaning, and they have a lot of built-in functions. Hence, you need not code everything from scratch to write a C program. There are a lot of built-in constructs available. So you need not write everything from scratch when you write a program. You can make use of already existing contents, and on top of it, you can create your own content. C is a highly portable language because it's a high-level language. It's not machine dependent. You can execute a C program which was developed on any computer, on any other computer, without little or literally no modifications. Hence, it's highly portable. C language supports structured programming. So it divides the problem into sub-problems and codes it in the form of function modules and blocks. Because of this modular kind of structure, C programs can be easily debugged, tested, and maintained. And yet another feature of C language is its ability to extend itself. So as I told you, C has a rich set of library functions available. It also allows a programmer to add his own functions to the library. So with availability of functions, what happens is the programming task becomes very simple. So therefore, C is popular because it's a reliable, simple, and easy to use language. And it's a small block structured programming language. It's a programming, it's a portable language, which means that if you write a program on one system, that program can be run on any other system with little or no modification. It has a big set of operators. Hence, any sort of calculation statements and comparison statements can be written in C program. And the C language has provided freedom of data storage to the programmer. So he need not worry about how the data and program is stored in the system and how it executes. He can simply make use of the data types and library functions, and he can concentrate on writing accurate programs. So now, why to study C? So as I told you, many new languages have come after C, but still, why C is so popular? Because C, during 1980, it was used for programming the microcomputers, and it was used to develop Unix operating system, and it was also useful. The Unix operating system had its own versions suitable for personal computers, mini computers, microcomputers, and mainframe computers. And also, not only the operating system, the C language was preferred for even application softwares like word processing softwares, spreadsheets, compilers, interpreters, database softwares, and so on. So C is an extremely flexible language. It can be used to write system softwares as well as application softwares. And there is no match for this flexibility advantage of C language to any other programming languages. Hence, you need to study C. Hence, C language is still there in the computer science syllabus. The first, very first programming language which is taught to computer science students is the C language. So, to name a few specific kinds of softwares where C language is used, is C language is used to write operating systems, language compilers, assemblers, text editors in which you will write the programs, print spoolers, network driver softwares, and modern program writing. For modern program writing also, C is useful to write databases, to write interpreter softwares, and to write utility softwares to maintain the computer parameters and computer performance statistics on the computer. We use utility softwares for writing utility softwares as well. C language is used. So that was about a brief introduction to C programming language. Thank you.